All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is John Shmyr. He is the Vice President of Exploration for Murchison Minerals. And John, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Hi, Steve. Great to see you again.
So you're on site getting prepared for the winter exploration program that's beginning at the BMK deposit. John, tell me a little bit about some of the work that was put in to get you to this particular point.
Yeah, no, absolutely, Steve. Yeah, we've done a lot of work. We've sat down, we went to the fundamentals back on the project again, and we brought in subject matter expert Dr. Stephen Piercy, and we really rebuilt our geologic model for the project. So it's all kind of culminated to this point, so we're really excited to get back out here and start doing work again.
Yeah, so you're going to be doing a drilling program, and when you say you redid the model, can you sort of explain to us what you thought was missing that you needed to add in there and that you're hopefully going to be able to utilize the drilling program to help with?
Yeah, so what we did notice is that the BMK deposit has very rich zinc grades, and in order to get grades that rich, you require what's called zone refining in a VMS deposit. And you know, fundamental to a zone refined VMS deposit is a copper stockwork zone, and we haven't yet identified that zone. So that's what we're really looking to target for this project. So we're looking to hopefully find that zone. We've lined up some great targets.
And just so investors understand, that's an important part of a project like this, is that copper portion of it. Can you sort of explain to us why that's so significant?
Yeah, well, you know, for example, the Mechlevina Bay deposit owned by 4N Mining, that's only 175 kilometers southeast of here, sorry. And it, you know, the copper stockwork zone actually makes the bulk of their resource. So it can add a considerable size to your resource that's there. And, you know, we've already have a very sizable deposit in the ground, the BMK deposit. You know, we've got 2.1 million tons indicated and 7.6 million tons inferred. So identifying that copper stockwork zone could, you know, significantly add to that resource.
Okay. So as I mentioned, about 3,500 meters in total, you're going to be drilling. What areas are you going to be looking at, John?
So we've identified three targets. We've got our CST zone. That's a geophysical anomaly. It's only 400 meters directly along strike of the deposit, similar size and conductance. And it's been undrilled. So we're really excited to test that target, as well as we have the BMK North and South extension zones. So those are directly adjacent to the deposit itself. And they're step outs from some pretty significant copper grades that had historically been drilled.
And John, is the plan to take the results of this one and then decide the next stage and next phase of where you're going to go for the rest of the year? Is that sort of the plan?
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, we've also have a lot of regional targets that we're also excited to get back to. You know, we've identified 37 kilometers of prospective strike length. We've got mineralization now at three zones along there. So, you know, that will certainly factor into it, as well as, you know, getting back to these regional targets. But, you know, we're in a very underexplored belt of rocks, very similar to the prolific VMS district that is Flin Flon. So, you know, we see a lot of potential in this project.
All right, John, we'll leave it there. Good luck with everything. Good to talk to you as well. Thanks very much.
All right. Thanks, Steve.
All right. John Shmyr, the Vice President of Exploration for Murchison Minerals.